Sunday, December 15th, late afternoon, news breaks on violent clashes between police and youths and students protesting against the Citizenship Amendment Act in Delhi's Jamia area. What followed was a series of violent attacks and detentions through the evening and early Monday morning. As these developments took place, the social media started getting flooded with different reports about the events, some true and some unverified. But what really happened? At 2:30 p.m., over 1,000 people, including students and locals from Jamia, took out a community march in opposition to the new Citizenship Amendment Act, or CAA. The marching students went from the nearby areas of Zakir Nagar and Batla House and moved to Shaheen Bagh, shouting slogans in opposition to the act. This march would have proceeded to Parliament. At 4:30 p.m. in Jamia, the march was stopped by the police, who lathi-charged the protesters and fired tear gas shells against them. Some of the protesters were accused of torching at least two buses, but this information is yet to be verified. All those who were marching were lathi-charged and hit with tear gas by the Delhi police. At 6 p.m, after several clashes, the police pushed the students back towards the university. The cops surrounded the campus, barricaded the gates and entered the campus, firing tear smoke shells. At 6:20, tear gas bombs were thrown in the library and the mosque, where students were taking shelter from the violence, leading to many students being severely injured.
तरीके से हमारा इस बंदे का पूरा आंख फोड़ दिया है और वहां पे एक बंदा पूरा बेहोश पड़ा हुआ है।
At 7:35 p.m., Jamia Chief Proctor Wasim Ahmed Khan gave out a statement saying, "The police entered by force. No permission was given. Our staff and students are being beaten up and being forced to leave the campus."
पुलिस ने लोकल को करके चार नंबर से गेट से घुसकर और पुलिस ने यानी पूरे एरिया में हमारे अंदर कैंपस में घुसकर हमारे गर्ल्स को हमारे बॉयज को हमारे स्टाफ मेंबर्स को मारा है लड़कियों को मारा है लाइब्रेरी में घुस के मारा है मस्जिद में बच्चे चले गए थे मस्जिद में जाकर मारा है और हम इस चीज को कंडेम करते हैं हम इसके खिलाफ एफआईआर कराएंगे पुलिस के खिलाफ सर
पुलिस डिनाइड ऑल क्लेम्स ऑफ एनी शॉट्स बीइंग फायर्ड आफ्टर 7:30 p.m. द सीआरपीएफ बिगन अलाउिंग द स्टूडेंट्स टू वॉक आउट ऑफ द कैंपस इन स्मॉल ग्रुप्स विद देयर आर्म्स रेज्ड अराउंड द सेम टाइम सम स्टूडेंट्स सेड They saw 11 boys and 2 girls being taken away by the police in a bus while being beaten. Around 8:30 p.m, several students, teachers and lawyers gathered at Kalkaji police station where many Jamia students were being held, many of whom were injured and required medical attention. The police were not allowing anyone to enter. At 9 p.m, responding to the brutal violence by police on the protesters, over 250 people from across the city gathered outside the old Delhi police headquarters at ITO and blocked the road, demanding the release of the detainees and the removal of security forces from the campus. In other cities too, students of different universities took out solidarity marches to show their support to Jamia and raise their voices against the brutal misuse of power by the police. Meanwhile, violence erupted in Aligarh Muslim University, where students were protesting against CAA and in solidarity with the people of Jamia. Over 50 students were injured and many arrested. At midnight, after pressure from social activist Harsh Mandar and his team of advocates, the Minority Commission issued an order to SHO of Kalkaji Police Station demanding immediate release of the detained students. At 3:30 a.m, after over 6 hours, the protest at ITO was finally called off when the police released all the students who had been detained earlier in the day without any access to lawyers. Over 12 hours of chaos in the capital of the country. Students beaten and harassed. Police using brute force on students for protesting. Leaders from various opposition parties giving statements joining the protest. With all this underway, here is what the Prime Minister has to say. The Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 was passed by both houses of parliament with overwhelming support. large number of political parties and MPs supported its passage. This act illustrates India's centuries-old culture of acceptance, harmony, compassion, and brotherhood. A government that seeks to throw out an entire community of people from this country by not granting citizenship to only Muslims. What is this acceptance, harmony, and brotherhood the PM is talking about?